So let's start today's episode with a battle, a bigger battle, because the battles we had so far were really small. So I decided to skip one battle and just jump to the next one, which
we
is bigger.
Grey Phoenix
Look at that.
Steals
Look
relief
at that.
Supplies, then repackages them for the city's alien populace. This buys them goodwill, which lets them operate in the open.
They withhold food and medicine from their own people. Now we know what Grey Phoenix truly is.
Exactly. They steal the food and then they give it out. Is that a Jedi Knight? Anyway, the artwork is pretty good in the game. Roll it by example. So that's Cherub, and that's Verge, Claymore, and Terminal. Okay, let's breach.
Reaching in.
I think the bonuses might be randomized or something. Now even Cherub can kill someone. Can you hit the python? Yeah, please hit the python. Well, let's kill the adder. You can kill a legionnaire with your shotgun. No, it's a risk to miss the python. And yeah, depending on the agents you take in your missions and what training they have, the missions can be 10 times easier than what you might expect. How about if I try to do a breach? No, that won't work.
Now that's protection.
Protect yourselves at all time. Whatever, just try to do something. Oh, you actually hit him. That's amazing, Cherub. These guys are so far behind. Yeah, he'll destroy cover for both of those agents, so I have to be fast. That's kind of a cheap trick, I think, because there's no way to avoid that from happening. Now, I can't really reach him, that's the problem. Sure, let's try with Battle Madness. No, that won't work. Okay, let's try the Stupor then. Okay, let's actually capture some of them alive this time. Yeah, let's not take any chances. Let's just Overwatch.
Check your zone.
Maybe he has a better shot if I do it like this. Also, those are civilians. Even though they look like strong, able-bodied mutants, they're just civilians. Okay, take a long shot. Of course you missed. Okay, let's get everyone to relative safety. Okay, one more shot, and that didn't kill him. Yeah, it's so funny to see the mutants in such a weak position. That one killed the python, oh, but that was my main plan. Yeah, go for the charge bash.
Thought I had it.
Yeah, it was a good plan anyway. Guys, get out, get out. Wait, don't kill any civilians. That's extremely bad. 4 damage. Oh, come on. That's just not fair. Stunning people like he's the best hacker in the world. Look at him. Do I want to do anything with you? I mean, I don't really want to kill the python, but looks like I will be forced to do it. That python lived way longer than it should have. This guy is like Charles Xavier. He seems to be the strongest out of all of them. Verge. Okay, let's kill this guy because he's really getting on my nerves. So many wasted turns because of him. Okay, reload, relock, and refocus your efforts on the bar.
It's not every day you crash a back alley wrestling match.
Exactly. By the way, the things that are fighting in that boxing arena or that cage were the robots from XCOM 1 and 2, the ones with the corrosive thing, the mech suits. Pinpoint. Okay, then Shiro will go first with Verge, Claymore, and Terminal. Breach.
Stay behind me.
Yeah, you're the one that's getting shot in all the missions. Okay, kill the Adder. Kill the Python. This is going surprisingly well. Oh, that Legionnaire will be trouble. That Legionnaire will be so much trouble. So he will act next. Who is that Virgin? Look at him, he's in such a bad position. I have to give him a shield. Okay, take your chances with that shot. Well, that was amazing. Terminal, well, that's not fair. I didn't plan for that. Okay,
your frustration.
That's another way of saying it. You're in the best position to actually hit this guy from behind with a critical shot. It was not a critical shot, but it will do. It will do. Hmm, 74 or 50. Let's actually play the smart game. Ah, this is not the smartest play, but okay, let's do it. Can't really do anything. Well, I don't want him to be a main target. Okay, let's just put him over here.
Where? Oh, I see.
Shrapnel, out.
If they don't move, they'll be shredded by that grenade, but I think they'll move. Yeah. That's to be expected. Oh, that's bad. Ouch. Ouch. I could almost feel him shooting me and destroying his health. Sadly, Terminus has to heal herself. I don't want... If I remember correctly, you only heal half HP between missions. So we have to make sure everyone is at least at a decent HP. Well, that did the trick. But this guy is so protected over there. Kinetic shield for Claymore, of course. I don't know how to approach this situation. Just fire at him until we hit him. Well, that was a hit. I guess no one will be captured alive. Or will someone be captured alive? Okay, let's just... Let's just take a chance. This is a very, very bad idea.
I will fire if they reposition.
We are ready for them. Heading over there.
Can you hit him over the... What?
Targets.
Oh, I pressed two times the free button. Okay, that worked. Okay, we even captured one alive. Now it's time for the hardest mission.
Packaging supplies in the next room. If you recover a sample, we can find where they're coming from.
Along with Grey Phoenix. They are more than ready for a last stand.
So this is the hardest mission. Even though you think this was easy, this is the hardest one. I think there will be so many more people. Secure entrance. Well, if it's secure, I'll take it. Now, the problem with these missions is that they are so long that sometimes you'll just have to restart all of them in order to complete the last one. By the way, this is still on the expert difficulty, so...
It's go time!
I think I play... I mean, I played this before and there were at least 6 enemies in here. 6 enemies. Okay, take a lucky shot. That was an extremely lucky shot. No, take the shot that has the bigger chance to hit. We have no options here. Right in the ass. See, this is what happens when you look the other way when there is a firefight going on. You'll get shot in your back. By the way, this is a mission where you have to complete it extremely fast.
Eyes on the supplies. Grab a sample and get out.
There is a paladin over there, but this time we really have to capture the supplies. Oh, terminal is in such a bad position. I don't know what to say about this mission. It's so, so hard. ...38 chance to hit and he's basically close enough to... I don't know, hit him with his with her rifle. Well, not exactly, but she can at least... I don't know, throw something at him.
And stay down.
Well, that works. Sadly, that was kind of dangerous. Let's not do that again. This guy needs to be stunned, because otherwise he'll just, I don't know, eat one of my members. Now, the thing that has to be killed first is the paladin, because he can actually buff his own units. And that's the worst thing anyone can do in the game, buff them. The paladin is like Verge, except with the more defensive positions in mind. And you may be wondering, why didn't I just kill the adder with the paladin? Well, you'll see once he uses his abilities. Hey, no. Don't be smart on me. This is not the place to get smart with me.
Shifting my position.
Be quick about it.
Please, if you hit him, I'll forever... Oh... Oh, that was a brilliant shot by Claymore. Brilliant, brilliant shot.
Protected from all angles.
Yeah. That's exactly what she needed. I guess I'm not surprised. I mean, I hit so many good shots. I had to miss one or two. That's the worst thing he could have done. I hate when I don't have the option to do anything. Kill the adder or shoot at the python. Well, I have no choice here. This could be very dangerous what I'm about to do, but I think that would have been good. Yeah, now this guy. Okay, the enemies will start coming.
Moving. Check your fire.
Get the sample and go away as fast as possible. So I think the next turn will be the one that all the enemies come. Let's put the shield on Claymore just to be safe. Can you kill the other? If you kill him, you are the best shot ever in the game and in the history of XCOM. No, you're not. Okay, now the enemies come in, and this is where the part where people will say that they hate this game, especially for this mechanic. Look at how many turns I had to complete and kill those guys. She's still poisoned even though she had the shield on. Well, that's not really fair, is it? Don't miss. Well, I guess I could have taken her into a better position.
No way out.
Okay, now let's make sure all people evacuate safely. Oh, he missed. Okay, let's try to get. I mean, the hardest part in this game is to actually get everyone out safely. It doesn't matter how many enemies you kill, it doesn't matter what you do. I thought that was a stupor, but he missed.
Full up.
Oh, I actually hit the other guy instead. Ah, well, that works as well.
Covering ground.
Oh, he completely missed. Get away from there as fast as possible because reinforcements will still keep coming. At this point, I don't want to say anything anymore and I just want to leave this awful, awful place. So they will move.
Yeah,
Claymore is the most exposed one because he will act after those guys. Huh. Civilian, keep your head down. She's still poisoned. Well, I'm not sure if I should just run away or start firing at them. Oh, dashing it is, because enemies will come next turn, again.
Crossing over.
Yeah, this is the part where I don't like the game at all, because so many enemies will come that you just can't stand and fight, and you're forced to make stupid decisions like this one. Don't capture him. He lost the kinetic shield already. And now Claymore might get down and I might miss the whole mission. Oh, demolition. That's a good choice. He's safe. Oh, your soldiers need so much mobility because of these things. Don't do anything silly. Don't do anything silly. Okay, he missed, fortunately for me. Now, if I was a stupid man, I would just shoot and kill that guy and then leave. Ah, why not? He didn't kill him. He didn't kill him. Okay, that was the stupidest move in the XCOM history. I should have just left. I thought you'd kill him and then I would have enough time to run away, but no. He didn't kill him. How could you not kill him when it was your last shot? Actually, I wanted to test something out. Let's see how good their accuracy is and how much they will hit him. Oh, they're actually hitting him pretty well because he has no cover. Oh, they are really going to kill him, right? Well, it's a sad moment. Fortunately for us, we have the load game from the 8th round, so I think this will be better, yeah. I don't know what to say, the reinforcements mechanics really need to be worked again because one enemy at a time is not a problem, two enemies is not a problem, but getting 6 or 7 enemies in a few turns, it's going to kill your unit. So I guess the mods will be focused on reducing the enemy reinforcements and I should really look up a mod for that. On the other hand, I might just, you know, play it a little longer like this. Yeah, let's just reload the save and see how much they miss. Bye guys, I hate all of you. I hate all of you, you jerks. Lucky for us, the system is kind of forgiving with all the... I guess I could have used the beast. The system is kind of forgiving with the save point system because every round you get a save. But playing this on Iron Man would be totally a total nightmare. Excellent, we rescue civilians, how? And this was only 8 rounds and it was 20 minutes. 20 minutes of intense gameplay for that. Whew, I'm almost sweating down here. It's so hard to actually do all those things and think about it. Remember, this is the second time I'm playing that mission, so I kind of knew what to expect, but otherwise it would have been impossible to do it from the first attempt. So, minus 2 unrest, credits, Ellerium, and intel.
Okay. Excellent work. With their influence reduced, Gray Phoenix won't be able to operate in plain sight.
No Dark Event. We still don't have the faction leader. Finally, a new recruit. High damage, cover destruction. Surrender not, I'm fine with either of that. Finding nearby enemy. Battering ram. Well, let's see. So, close quarter. We have Zephyr, he's a hybrid probably. Disarm, disorient, stun or root. That's interesting. So he's a melee. Move fast or die slow. And their aim is actually much better than... I guess he still has bad aim. Dead eye. Oh, that's pretty good. Oh, you can fire a pistol in his main weapon as well. Precision shooting multiple shots. So he's basically a pistol thing. But he has 9 health, 12 mobility. His mobility is better. Well, you know what I'm going to choose, right? The best option for me would have been to choose the blue blood, but I'm choosing Axiom because I want mutants on my squad.
Whisper, there's a problem.
Axiom, welcome. What's wrong?
I noticed someone took the biggest locker.
Yep, that was me. I knew you'd get here eventually and grab it so no one else would.
Hmm.
Don't worry, I'll move my stuff.
Yeah, that's the problem. I already did. Violently.
You... didn't you see the note?
Yeah, afterward. I'll replace what I can.
The voice acting for the mutants is trash. It's trash. No other way of putting it. Trash, trash, trash. Okay, so now we have a mutant. The things are going pretty well for us. So that means things have to go bad for us. Okay, sadly, Cherub is one of my best agents. Now, I really love him. Before I didn't like him so much, but now, the more I think about it, the best. Wait a minute, isn't he wounded or something? Let's check with the training. So how do you see if someone is wounded?
Gray Phoenix is armed with restricted weapons. We don't know their source. That's where you come in. Determine where they're getting all their toys.
Yeah, also... we have a field team over there. Mission lost and found. Intel. Intel is so important. I want more intel. We could do that. But Old Town is getting very bad. We have to do the cutting edge mission next. That's for sure. Can also get another team. So this is security. So this sector is basically on lockdown. Unrest will never rise very much in this one. But also need some other teams. Yeah, I'll just tinker on my own. But that was a good mission. See you next time. Bye.